Okay, so what needles do you really need for your embroidery machine? We're answering that question in this video. Welcome to the Sewing Report. I'm Jen, and this channel is all about sewing crafts and DIY projects. And I have gotten a lot of questions about machine embroidery and the machine I use, the PE800 by Brother. I love this machine, and I'm also gonna link all of my supplies below in the description box. So if you are curious about what I use, that is it. So I've gotten a viewer question that I thought was interesting and that I would try to answer. And they asked, what kind of needles do you need for your machine? Do you need different needles for different projects? And the answer is yes, but not as many needles as you would think. So I'm gonna cut to the chase. I generally only use 3 different needles for different projects. Believe it or not, my default needle for the embroidery machine is actually a ballpoint needle. These are by Oregon and they're 75 over 11. Now you're probably like, you know, Jen, why do you use a ballpoint needle for all these different projects? So I started off with the ballpoint needles on knit fabrics. The difference between regular needles and ballpoint needles is that regular needles can actually tear your knit fabric. Knit fabric is all looped, so you want to use a ballpoint needle because it won't pierce the fabric. It will slide in between all of those loops that forms during the knitting process, like if you're actually knitting, but they're just a lot smaller. So I know that sounds weird, but after I started using these for like t-shirts or for, you know, knitted stuff, I had just kind of kept the needle in for other projects and everything was stitching out fine. So I've done quilting cotton with this. I've done like dress shirts with it. So a lot of woven fabrics I found are pretty compatible with these needles as well. I've done hats with this. So I know it sounds a little strange. And another thing I want to tell you is that if you're pretty new to this whole world, generally the larger the sizes, so the typical sizes are like 75 over 11, 80 over 12, 90 over 14, or like 100 over 16. Generally, the larger the first number, the bigger the eye of the needle is. So what that means is that you can generally use thicker thread with the bigger numbers. So if I'm, say, using a 60 weight thread, which is pretty thin, you know, I could use like a 70 or a 75 needle. If I'm using a thicker thread, like if I'm using, I think I have like a 12 weight thread, which is very thick, you would definitely want to use something 100 or above. If I'm using like a 40 weight thread, which is a little bit thicker than a 60 or 50 weight, generally I'll go with like an 80 or like a 90 needle. So with thread thickness, the higher the number, the thinner it is. With needle sizes, generally the bigger the number, the bigger the eye is. So I know that's a little bit backwards, but generally I guess that's how it works. So I know it seems a little strange that I use a ballpoint needle, but I got these off of Amazon and they've been working pretty well with a lot of different types of projects. So yes, I've been able to do knit fabric, woven fabric, towels, even hats and freestanding lace, with an exception, and that is with metallic or opalescent threads. You certainly want to use specific metallic needles for that. I've ran into all sorts of issues when I was trying to use your standard needles. So if you're using a metallic or an opalescent, definitely go with a metallic needle. I'm using these 90 over 14. I use this for the freestanding butterflies when I was using like gold thread, silver thread, or the stuff with the cool like shimmer in it, the opalescent stuff. Those were by Madeira, and these needles are by Klasse, and they worked pretty well. They have a bigger and longer scarf for the needle. That's that little indent that's in the needle. And that helps the thread move through with less friction. And less friction is what you want with a specialty thread. So that is the instance where I will use the metallic needles. Now the third and last type of needle I'm going to tell you about, and this is a fairly recent introduction, is the Microtex needle. And you're going to want to use this for any fabric that is like a nylon, a ripstop nylon, like a polyester, sort of like the fabric you use in like, you know, duffel bags, windbreakers, those types of materials. You're going to have a much easier time if you use a Microtex needle. And that's only for those types of fabrics. Now I know there's all different types of needles and there's all different types of fabrics and material. Admittedly, I have not done a lot of embroidery on real specialty material like leather. I have done a little bit on glitter vinyl. Now that, I think I did use the ballpoint needles and it worked out okay, but I think I need to experiment more before I try to recommend a needle specifically for that material. But if you're watching out there and you have a lot of experience with, you know, unusual fabrics, feel free to share your own tips below in the comments. Obviously, I've done quite a few different types of projects. I have not done them all, but I just wanted to answer that question on what types of needles I generally use. And I know it seems probably a little strange that I use a ballpoint needle for a lot of different projects. Hopefully that did answer your question. And I do have quite a few other videos on machine embroidery and the machine I've been using, the Brother PE800. So you're welcome to check those out as well. I've done a lot of different types of projects here. And if there's something you'd like to see that you don't already, let me know in the comments and I may consider it in the future. I'm Jennifer with The Sewing Report, and I will see you guys next time.